Can you identify this sound? If you happen to be in the business of manufacturing threaded parts, it's almost certain you can. You're listening to the sound of a high-production automatic screw machine. To the uninitiated, this sound may be little more than factory noise. But once you're familiar with it, it's a reassuring sound that tells you production is flowing evenly and surely. This is the sound that accompanies one of the most progressive phases of modern manufacturing. Basic to all metalworking industry are high-production, precision threading tools. These key tools make possible the high degree of accuracy and interchangeability on which our entire mass production system is based. Here is a geometric 2-inch Model DD stationary self-opening die head mounted on a turret lathe. Fundamentally, a die head is a threading tool. It is used to cut external threads of precise form, pitch, and lead. A self-opening die head permits the head to be rapidly removed from the stock without unscrewing the head from the work. This feature allows for high-speed operation and prevents damage to the new threads. Although this die head contains many separate parts, its major components are the skeleton, the cam, the back part, and the shank of the tool. The skeleton holds the chasers in accurately ground slots. The cam has four push buttons which snap into the chaser lug slots for chaser retention. In addition, the cam has four protruding lugs which, when partially rotated, cause the chaser to close or open. The back part holds the die head together. The shank adapts the die head to the machine in which it is to be used. Now let's see exactly how this self-opening die head operates. In this special demonstration, we can see the rotating stock as it is engaged by the chasers of the advancing die head. When a predetermined length of thread has been cut on the stock, longitudinal travel is stopped. The stock continues to rotate, however, and since it is rotating and the newly cut threads are engaged with the chaser teeth, the stock exerts a pull on the die head, which soon grows strong enough to actuate the opening mechanism, and the chasers snap back into the skeleton away from the stock, as shown here in slow motion. When the chasers have disengaged the work, the operator returns the die head to its starting place. One simple movement of the closing handle brings the chasers back to the cutting position. Thus, in a matter of seconds, the die head has completed its cycle and is ready to thread another piece. So much for the ABCs of die head operation. Now let's see, with this DS convertible model, why geometric die heads have been leaders in the threading tool business for more than half a century. First, we'll install a set of chasers, a procedure common to all stationary die heads, and then we'll put the tool to work. Before inserting the chasers, trip the tool and pull up the stop plunger so that the cam lugs clear the chaser slots. Now slip the chaser marked number one into the slot marked number one. Push the chaser toward the center of the die head until the push button snaps into the chaser cam lug slot. Slip chasers number two, three, and four into their respective slots. The insertion of genuine geometric chasers in geometric die heads is simplicity itself. When all four chasers have been inserted, close the die head with the closing handle. The chasers are now in cutting position. Before actually cutting a thread, set the chasers to the exact size desired. This is done by adjusting the chasers to fit a gauge or sample part. Chasers are set to the desired size by means of two opposed adjusting screws. Another outstanding feature of the DS die head is its aligning shank, which can be set to compensate for misalignment. This is accomplished by loosening the two square head screws at the rear, allowing the head to float freely. Feed the head to a true running work blank until the chasers are fully engaged. Stop the machine with the chaser still engaged with the blank. Tighten the two square head binding screws and the job is done. Another case of ingenuity resulting in increased accuracy and reduced downtime. After adjusting for misalignment, you're ready to cut a thread. The die head advances to the stock, cuts the thread smoothly, evenly, and close to the shoulder, then trips open. By slowing down the machine, we can watch the action of the opening mechanism. As the die head approaches the end of the thread, the outside trip gauge contacts a stop on the machine. The rearward movement of the trip gauge causes the die head to open. With the machine still slowed down, we can see the action of the DS as it operates with a pull-off trip. High production setups demand the utmost in rugged construction and precise operation. The 9/16 DS head uses an outside trip on this automatic setup. Here, operating with a pull-off trip, is a 5/16 DS head. Now you see why the DS might be called four die heads in one. Just as the model DS is a star performer in the field of stationary die heads, the model KD rotary self-opening die head is a star in the field of rotary tools. Unlike the other tools we've seen so far, this tool rotates while cutting threads. The KD is opened and closed by a yoke and trip rod mechanism, which provides both positive opening and positive closing, and can be installed on almost any live spindle machine. Compact design and yoke tripping make the model KD ideally suited to jobs where there is little machine clearance. Chaser insertion is extremely easy with the KD. Simply push back the trip flange. This causes the die head to trip into the open position. Depress the stop lever in the adjusting ring and allow the springs to force the closing sleeve into the fully open position, ready for chaser insertion. Slip chasers into correspondingly numbered slots. A click announces the positive seating of each chaser. Close the die head by pulling the trip flange forward. The head will lock in the cutting position. Adjusting the chasers for correct cutting size is the last step before putting the KD to work. Loosen the adjusting binding screw and turn the adjusting ring until the desired thread size is obtained. Tighten the binding screw and the job is done. Could any other mechanical adjustment as precise as this be as simple? Here's another high production setup that demands the most reliable threading tools available. That's why you see the model KD die head at work here. This tool has everything a high-speed setup requires. Shoulder threading ability, rigid chaser support, positive locking, and right or left-hand threading. Although the tools demonstrated so far have been of the self-opening variety, Geometric also produces a broad line of solid adjustable die heads. The model DJ, for example, is made in a wide range of sizes, from large tools capable of cutting threads 6 inches in diameter to this little 5/16 model. Outstanding features of this fine tool are compact design, simple operation, positive chaser adjustment, close to shoulder threading, and important too, low initial cost. These are EJ5 solid adjustable die heads. Just 1 inch in diameter and weighing less than 5 ounces, they are faithful performers capable of cutting class 3 threads day after day. Supermetric projection chasers are furnished as standard equipment with the EJ5 to facilitate cutting to a shoulder. The tool has the advantage of easy chaser removal or adjustment and has a threading range up to number 10 and in pitches as fine as 120 threads per inch. Parts requiring these fine threads go into cameras, scientific instruments, eyeglasses, and timepieces, to name just a few. And here, at the other end of the scale, are a few large die heads. The model CT is a taper threading die head. This one is equipped with an inside trip mechanism. This model D is made especially for hand screw machines and turret lathes. We have already seen a small model DD self-opening die head in action. Now here's a 3 1/2 inch model. This giant head is a Model C self-opening die head. Yes, Geometric offers precision tools in a wide range of sizes. Complementing its broad line of die heads, which produce accurate external threads, is Geometric's line of precision collapsing taps. Like the die head, the collapsing tap is fundamentally a thread cutting tool. It is used to cut internal threads of precise form, pitch, and lead. Because the tap collapses at the end of its threading operation, it can be rapidly withdrawn from the stock without unscrewing it from the work. This feature permits fast operation and avoids damage to the new threads. Main components of the Geometric collapsing tap are the skeleton ring, the trip plate, the closing sleeve, the adjusting ring, and the plunger. The skeleton of the tool acts as a self-contained shank. The tap skeleton holds the chasers in accurately ground slots. A tongued plunger engages the rib on each chaser and its action, backward or forward, causes the chasers to collapse or reset. Let's see exactly how the Class S collapsing tap operates. All chasers engage the work simultaneously as the nose of the tap enters the work. A cutaway tap and a piece of cutaway stock enables us to look inside the tap at the end of its longitudinal travel. The trip plate on the tap meets the end of the workpiece. In slow motion, we can see that the rearward movement of the trip plate causes the spring-loaded plunger to move backward, collapsing the chasers, disengaging them from the work. With this, the tap can be rapidly withdrawn. A movement of the closing handle brings the chasers back to the cutting position. The tap has now completed its cycle and is ready to thread another piece. To satisfy every known machine requirement, Geometric has made the Class S collapsing tap truly a universal tool. Four easily interchangeable trips enable this tap to be used on a variety of machines. This is a stationary type Class S tap with a trip plate. It is designed for use on hand screw machines and turret lathes. It is collapsed by the trip plate and reset by the closing handle. For use on drill presses or live spindle machines, the S tap is also equipped with a trip plate. The tool is collapsed by the trip plate and reset by a yoke or fork which contacts the back part of the closing sleeve. When high production tapping is to be done on automatic screw machines, chucking machines, or drill presses, the Class S tap is equipped with a sleeve trip. The tool is collapsed and reset by a yoke riding in the sleeve. Here is the same tap equipped with a lever trip. It is ideal for short runs, sizing, and special jobs where the unusual construction of the part to be tapped requires hand operation. The tap is both collapsed and reset by the lever. The S-tap will tap three distinct kinds of jobs. Most common of tapping operations is through-hole tapping. The tap threads the part through its entire thickness. A more difficult and less common tapping operation is bottoming tapping, where threads are cut to the bottom of a blind hole, or as in this case, to a shoulder. To do this tough job, the S-tap must be equipped with a bottoming cap and overhanging chasers. Special requirements are imposed on tools used for deep hole tapping. The entire tool, but particularly the shank, must be exceptionally rigid or the tool will wander, causing oversized, out-of-round threads. Regardless of the requirement, there is a geometric tap for every tapping job. In addition to collapsing taps, geometric produces a variety of solid adjustable taps. Within its capacity, this tap will do any job that a conventional solid tap will do. Where time for backing out is unimportant, where space is limited, or whenever a solid tap is desired, the SJ is recommended. Chaser adjustment on this tool is extremely simple. Just loosen one adjusting screw and tighten the opposing adjusting screw. Because of this positive size adjustment feature, the SJ will tap to closest tolerances. Interchangeable chasers enable this rugged tool to take the place of several solid taps. The SJ will even do bottoming tapping if overhanging chasers and a bottoming cap are installed. For economy's sake, chasers for solid adjustable taps are interchangeable with chasers for collapsing taps. Ground thread chasers are standard for both tools. Chasers for die heads are divided into two general types, regular and projection. The regular chaser, used for straightaway threading, is the more common. The projection chaser derives its name from the fact that part of its cutting face projects beyond the front of the chaser. This important feature permits cutting close to a shoulder. Threads on regular and projection chasers vary in profile, depending on the method used to produce them. A chaser with this angular profile was produced by either grinding or milling. A tapped chaser has this concave profile, which indicates it was produced by the cutting action of a tap or hob. There are seven different types of geometric chasers. They are the D, the K, the EJ, the tangent, and the circular for die heads, and the S and SL for taps. Supermetric is the trademark of Geometric's line of super finished chasers, which are manufactured under a patented process. Supermetric grinding of every surface pays off in terms of smoother action in the head, longer life, and more accurate threads. Here in the inspection department, chasers pass under the watchful eyes of experts trained in the science of inspection. These chasers have been inspected a dozen or more times in preparation for the final test. Here's visual proof of precision and manufacturing skill. Notice that the chaser is a perfect match for the reference lines on the face of the magnifying comparator. To make sure chasers will perform to established high standards, they are put to work doing the job expected of them. This is the payoff. They must cut a clean, accurate thread that is more than just satisfactory. Only after meeting the most exhausting requirements is a geometric product prepared for delivery to its future owner. Because even the finest tools require sharpening after periods of hard usage, Geometric has developed the Style A chamfer grinding fixture. With this single tool, either ground or milled chasers can be rechamfered. The Style E universal chaser grinding fixture is designed for rechamfering all geometric conventional chasers. It can also be used for grinding the cutting face. Displayed here are examples of the entire geometric line. In this array of precision equipment, you'll find a tool to satisfy almost every threading requirement, whether the need be for a die head, either stationary or rotary, with conventional, tangent, or circular chasers. There are die heads large and small, self-opening and solid adjustable. And there are taps which solve almost all the high production tapping problems of a steadily growing industry. the clock, day and night, month after month, the chant of the machines goes on and on. Echoes and re-echoes in thousands of factories and shops across the country and throughout the world. Geometric's threading tool specialists are proud of their contribution to the industrial growth of our country. For over half a century, the Geometric Tool Company has been serving America and the world through the production of finer threading tools.